My name is Kees-Jan van der Made. I'm director of Semaso, a company specialized in finding sediment management solutions for ports and shipping channels. Emden is in all aspects a regular sea harbor. It ships around 6 million tons annually. Like most harbors, Emden is affected by a surplus of mud. The mud being an obvious side product of the way most harbors are placed, near a sea delta or a river, that's causing the constant flow of mud. Where Emden stands out is the ditch sluice, which is in every harbor. It's also present in the shipping lane. Emden stopped dredging over 30 years ago.
Normally, the maximum draft of a vessel is determined by measuring the top of the mud layer and accepting a margin of approximately 10%. In Emden, the maximum draft for vessels lies 3 meters below the top of the mud layer. This is possible due to the special characteristics of the mud.
This is a sample of regular mud that you would find in a harbor. If I put this weight on it, you will see that it won't sink. By stirring this mud, it will turn into a thick fluid.
In this tank, we simulated a natural harbor environment with a mud layer. At the bottom, there's a layer of sand. On top of it is about 3 centimeters of mud that we stirred one day ago. I'll show you what happens when a ship actually passes through this material. This is the ship that has enabled vessels to travel through 3 meters of mud in the harbor of Emden during the last 30 years. The mud is sucked from the bottom and pumped into the ship. During this process, the mud is stirred and aerated. Another pipe allows the processed mud to return to the bottom, leaving a thick blanket of navigable fluid mud.
We developed equipment to monitor safe shipping conditions. This is the sampler for fluid mud. The results of laboratory tests of these fluid mud samples is combined with measurements by the specially developed mud density profiler. In some cases, preliminary measurements may show that even without conditioning, the mud is navigable. Since Emden stopped dredging 30 years ago, they managed to keep the harbor navigable for only 1/10 of the cost that were involved in dredging. The method can also be used to deepen harbors and channels. Leaving a mud layer reduces additional sedimentation.
Not only is this method much cheaper than traditional dredging, but there are also environmental advantages. The disturbance of the environment is less. The CO2 footprint is less as there is no material being transported out of the area. An additional advantage is that the aeration of the mud during the process stimulates the natural breakdown of toxic substances for no additional cost.